Well, my name is Dr. Matthew Tesheri. I'm Canada Research Chair in Human Origins at Lakehead University and Research Associate in the Human Origins Program at the Smithsonian Institution. My specialty is paleoanthropology, so I study human origins and human evolution. The last few decades have been sort of a blossoming of paleoanthropological research. Lots of new findings from the human fossil record, lots of new findings from genetics, lots of new findings from a whole array of research that come together to provide new information about human origins. Several decades ago, each fossil was put into its place in sort of one sort of single lineage, leading from early man through to, say, Neanderthal man through to us. However, as more and more people have found fossils throughout the old world, from Africa all the way through Europe and Asia, we now realize our evolutionary story is a lot more like the evolutionary story of other animals, that it wasn't just a simple linear evolution of features leading to us, that in fact our family tree is much more bushy, and there were lots of cousins, essentially, that unfortunately have gone extinct, and we're the only ones left of this otherwise quite diverse group. Our species, modern humans, Homo sapiens, first evolved in Africa roughly about 200,000 years ago. And we know that from the earliest fossil evidence of our species, as well as modern human genetics. So all the DNA in our bodies today lead back to a common ancestral population that was living about 200,000 years ago. Now, Neanderthals are essentially the descendants of earlier hominins that left Africa probably about 500,000. Years ago. You can look at it as the common ancestor that we share with Neanderthals. Part of that group left Africa around that time and then basically got isolated from the population still living in Africa. And roughly about 200,000 years ago, our species evolved from the populations that stayed in Africa, and Neanderthals evolved from those that had stayed in Eurasia. Well, we know that we shared the planet with Neanderthals, but Neanderthals are also very much like us. They have very large brains, they're larger bodied, their body proportions are the same as us, and they also used very sophisticated tools. And they lived in cold climates, you know, used fire in controlled ways. And so sharing the planet with something like that, which is otherwise, you know, very recognizably human, is easy for us to picture. But Homo frisiensis, when it was discovered, it also overlapped in time with our species, as well as Neanderthals, but was isolated often in the Indonesian island of Flores. Now, it's very surprising because it doesn't look like a Neanderthal, it doesn't look like us. It looks more like hominin species that we find in the fossil record roughly 1 to 3 million years ago in Africa. And yet, it's extremely far away and found in sediments that overlap with our species. So to see that we shared this planet not only with Neanderthals, but as well with another more distantly related cousin is really quite remarkable.